So what are those locators in Selenium that are available? So when it comes to Selenium, not only Selenium, any programming language, be it Java, be it Python, right? Anything, any programming language. So these are called as eight locators, which are going to help you to identify the element more on your application. The first one that I want to bring to your notice is class name, CSS selector, ID, name, link text, partial link text, tag name, and XPath. So class name. So how can I get this class name? Suppose take an example. Take an example. We have four text boxes available. We have four text boxes available in your application, four or five, okay? So we have some set of text box available on your application. Now for all these four text box, the font should be available as, for all these five text boxes, the font should be available as Calibri. Okay, and the size should be available as, the font size should be available as 20 pixel, okay? And the background color for them, and the background color should be available as some blue or red, whatever it may be. Background color equal to some blue or red, some color is going to be, okay? So if you observe carefully for all these elements, right? For all these elements, what happened here is the properties are going to be same. They're going to be come under the same category of the properties. So rather than writing for this text box, individual text box with individual properties, what the developer will do here is he will apply this class name for all these text boxes, such that all these text boxes, right, will have the same properties. So when there is a group of elements where you want to apply some common styling on top of them, right? So the developer is going to use the CSS property called as class. So class is going to determine you to select a group of elements. So to select the group of elements, right? We are going to be apply the common styling on them. So who is going to do this? The actual developer. So this class name is also come under, right? The CSS property name only. So which is going to be called as class name. So when you try to use your class name here, you may get a chance to identify one or more elements, because class name is the one which is going to help you to identify elements more elements on your application. So that is about your class name. So CSS selector. So CSS selector is going to be help you to identify the elements based upon their styling on the CSS properties. So where we want to discuss a more about your CSS selector. I'll be telling you in deep about your CSS selector. Now let's understand about this ID. So for all the elements, right, I should have these properties to be common. Okay. So depends upon the element, right? If I'm going to click on this particular text box, I should get some text. Only for this element alone, I want to get some text should be displayed when I try to click on this particular element. So if you want to identify an element more uniquely on the application, right? So we'll be using a attribute called it as ID. So ID is going to help you to locate an element more uniquely. So again, this ID, right? It might be a static ID or it might be a dynamic ID, where I'm going to explain you again by showing an example on this. And name. So, right, for each and every text box that is available on the application, right, the developer will give the property called it as a name. So, using that name, we need to identify this particular element, right? So, there is a facility for you to identify the element by its name also. So, link text and partial link text. So, these two properties are, right, are going to be helpful to identify only your links, which are going to be called as hyperlinks. Next one is going to be called as your tag name. So if you want to identify the elements based upon your tag name, I don't know how many links are available in my page. So if you want to identify the element based upon the HTML tags, then we are going to be using our tag name. And last but not the least, which is called as your export. So if you want to identify the elements on the DOM structure of the page, physical representation of elements, right, we'll be using the tool called export. The method called as export. I won't call it as a tool, the approach, right? We call it as export. So export is going to help you to identify the elements physically on the DOM structure of your application. So now we should be very much strong in writing your XPath and your CSS selector. So now let us understand, right, how to use these locators, all these 8 locators, in identifying the web elements on the web page. We'll understand that more.